profit. It's 7,53,580. So that is a bank account that we have got. Stock in hand is 3,49,000. Like 49,350, tax assets. Oh, you used input and output, yeah? Okay,
Yes, sir.
CGST input, CGST output. Okay, interesting. We'll see that actually. Good one to see that. Okay, so we have 437 and 10. Okay, so we'll see the different way of doing the same thing. Perfect. We just go down. And we have current liabilities. Okay, so here it is say 5,805 and 10,800. That's correct because these are in the sales that we got.
Yes.
Okay, 10,800. And the liquidity is 10 lakh. That's all. Right? Nothing else, right? That's all we have. Okay. Has everybody kind of noted this number? Okay. Now we can go to profit and loss statement. Okay, so our sale is 1,24,500. That is our sale. And then we have got 43,000 COGS. And then that's the profit is around 81,500. Okay, this is a simplistic one. Okay, now can we see the stock ledger and see what is the number available for laptop and desktop?
Okay.
How much we have got in laptop, or actually, we should say stock balance. But yeah, you can see the last entries for laptop and desktop. We need a number actually for the time being. How many laptops? I think stock balance is a better one to see. Or there is a column here, right? So you can see the balance quantity.
Balance quantity. Okay. Four.
Is 4 and 9. Yeah, that's correct. So we have got 4 laptops and 9 desktop, and we are getting an opportunity to sell 10 laptops and 10 desktops. So we're not going to manufacture, assemble anything. We're just going to sell it after buying it. So we'll buy it obviously at a lower price and sell at higher price so as to make some profit. Fair enough. So this is Nick Computers, right? Your company name is? Is your company name Nick Computers?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. So let us go ahead, Nick Computers. So let us create an opportunity now. And let us get opportunity. We have done it customer 01 and 02, right? So we'll take it from 03.
Okay.
That is gold, no? Yeah. 03 is good. And then yes, anything else that we do need to do here? Nothing. Okay, I think we are
Sir, in source.
Source, we can say something like walk-in. Okay. So source is basically how did you get it? In a sense, somebody walked in and put an order to us, or you did cold calling or anything like that. So this is a CRM part. Opportunity is part of CRM where it will basically we need to track. So this is more useful when there are many salespeople and they need to kind of record. So what happens in Salesforce management per se is that we have say 100 salespeople. And they will bring some business. And how do you really know whether they're doing work or not? Because the ultimate thing is okay, they'll get business, but it takes some time to ticket business. So you want to track it. So you will start with opportunity, then quotation, and all that. And there will be hundreds of opportunity. Out of it, maybe, you know, out of say 100, maybe 50 will ask for a quotation. Out of that, 20 will actually place an order. And this numbers will be obviously different. So, and you know, to get opportunity, you may need to have 1,000 leads all the way. So all that data comes in CRM. So CRM will basically track all that Salesforce, basically what they are doing, sales funnel, we'll call it. So that is what we are doing. So we are in the CRM world right now. I think this is good enough. Now we'll save it. Yeah. Okay, and the status is open right now. So that's what we need. Now we want to give a quotation. So, oh yeah, you can click on quotation. We have asked for a quotation, so we.
Sir, we need to add customer address.
No, not. I mean, it is required, but we'll not do it right now.
Okay.
We'll need to select the price list. Okay, this is a gold customer, so we need to pick up the price list. This is a gold customer, customer 03. Can somebody check and confirm? Customer 03 is a. Yeah, it's a gold customer. Okay, so that's fine. So, yeah, so we'll ask for this 10 desktop, 10 laptops. Let us say instead GST. Okay. Oh, is coming correctly? 9,000. Okay.
I think it's instead. Let's see. Okay.
Okay. Okay. You can just look at the tax breakup just to see it. Oh, okay. So that is correct. Okay. Okay, so we can
save.
Yes, we can save now. Yeah, check it again before submitting. Okay, so we've got the quotation done. And what is the next step now? So we'll now get a kind of a sales order, right? So that is what we can create. Yeah, that has come correctly. We should do some jugglery to get it done. Okay. Okay. Now, if you see there is some red dots are shown in the items. You just go there. You see the dot, right? Which is kind of a reddish kind of a thing. It basically indicates, what does it indicate? Anybody? There's a dot.
orange dot?
Yeah, orange dot is there. What does it indicate?
I think there is no stock. Yes. Limited
stock. Limited stock. If you can, yeah, so if you change it to maybe 2 or 3, it would disappear. You can check that out. I mean, just edit it, make it 1. Yeah, then that is kind of gone. The other one, the laptop is still showing. The laptop is still showing. I don't know why it should not show actually. You may want to just refresh. No, refresh will not help you.
I think okay. We have to save this first.
Sorry?
We have to save this, then...
It will give that. Okay. Anyway, I think we'll just stick to 10-10 only. So that is basically an indication. It's just an indication. I mean, when we go anyway, it should also give some kind of a warning for us that this is what is going on. So anyway, we save this now. So this is... okay. And let us try to submit it. Let us see what happens. Okay, so it has submitted it.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, what should be the next step now?
Sales invoice.
Okay, but before that, we have to deliver, right?
Okay.
So, can we make a delivery note now?
Okay, sir. Now submit.
Yeah, submit. Are you okay with submitting it?
Yes. Insufficient stock.
Yes. So now this thing is a challenge because we got a sales order, but we don't have enough stock with us. Stock. Right? Okay. So it will not get submitted. It will get saved, which is fine. So what we'll need to do now? Yes, what we'll need to do now?
We have to purchase this.
Yes, we need to purchase this. So we have got two suppliers, supplier 08 and supplier 09. We can supply the product. So we can place an order with them. So do you want to start with a quotation or do you want to directly put an order? Monica, how do you want to go ahead?
Yes, sir. Sorry, Sunaini there.
Achha, I'm asking. So now we need to buy this, right? So
right.
So should we ask for a quotation, follow that process, or should we directly go and put a purchase order on there?
Okay, sir. Purchase order.
Direct purchase order. Okay. We'll just put a purchase order. Can pick supplier 08 or 09, either one would be good. No.
No, here is a standard buying, no, sir.
Okay, do we have another buying list? I don't think we bought for the pure only have consumers, right? So, okay, we'll do a standard buying. The standard buying is okay. We need to put the values anyway. So we'll put laptop and desktop. And how much do you want to buy now?
10.
What is the shortfall? Is it you want to buy? I mean, that is a question that you as a business person should respond to. Would you like to buy only for fulfilling this order, or do you want to buy in extra? Either way, you
extra.
Okay, so you put your order number that you feel comfortable with. So you're pretty comfortable that, or pretty confident that you will get more orders going forward. Later on, ordering so much in advance. In advance. Yeah, now laptop, we need to get the numbers now. So for laptop, earlier we bought at 24,000. I think this time we can put 25,000 for laptop. And for desktop, you put 20,000. We got earlier 19,000. This time we'll take 20,000. Yeah. And this is instant key strength.
But sir, here is again orange.
I'm also wondering why it is showing orange there. Can you just click on the edit button there? Go down below, is there anything which is... I don't think we see anything different here, right? Everybody quantity on
available quantity warehouse.
Code. Okay, fair enough. Ticket. I think let us ignore that for the time being. Did you put 21? Yeah. Well, I think let us go ahead. Tax is something that we need to worry.
Here is amount and rate is not showing.
Some issue here. What could be the problem? What did you put in instant purchase? Did you have that?
Instant purchase.
Just go ahead. Just click on that instant purchase. Click on that instant purchase. No, just go down. Okay, just go. Where are we now? Okay. You didn't put it here. Okay, the item didn't have it. Sorry. Right. So our item didn't have it. So we need to go to the item. And put laptop and desktop. And we need to put in item tax template for it. So we had only for...
We need to go item tax template.
Do we have item tax template or GST? I think you have it, right? Just check item tax template first, whether we have it. We have GST 18%. Yeah, just click on the GST 18%. And you have it for CGST, yeah, you have 99%. Okay, so that this GST 8% we have to apply to laptop and desktop. It should have been applied. Let us check whether it is applied or not.
No, sir, for purchase, we applied 5%. No, IGST, CGST.
No, for laptop, it will be 18%. So, whether you buy item, it is same, whether you buy or sell, it is already applied 18% GST. For laptop and desktop both. Data sheet for text also, it is also mostly applied.
Yes, applied, just 18%.
It is applied. Okay. What could be a problem? It is not fetching it from there. Can you just go to the purchase order again and try it a couple of times to see what happens? No, it is calculating that 9,000 is calculating. It is 9 lakh, that is the number.
Total is showing, but amount and rate is not showing.
Okay, tax amount is not showing. Okay. The total is grant is showing, but it is not showing the tax amount. Okay, can you just select again instead? Just go ahead and select again that purchase tax template. Okay, try this out state. Does it work? No, it is not coming in. We got GST. Can you again check that instead purchase? Can just see the document. Just here only click, and there's an arrow that you will see. Here will be, yeah. Then just see the arrow. Yeah. Click on that arrow. Hold on. There you have selected instead. That's correct. And see GST. Okay, CGST input, SGST input. Oh, okay. So you have got CGST input and SGST input, right? That's accounted.
Right.
Okay. I think GST 18%, you have got CGST and IGST accounted, right? You just go to GST 18%. That item tax template.
Item tax template. GST 18%.
Yeah. Can go to the item tax template of GST 18%.
Yes, there is a GST 18%.
Actually, I don't see that. Are you sharing the screen?
Yes, sir. My screen.
Yeah, okay. It got frozen for me. What about others? Are others seeing?
Yeah. No, we are also not able to see.
We see instead purchase, can you see?
Yes, sir.
Is it visible, sir? No.
Actually, it is visible for me. It just show in-state purchase NC. What about others? Others also say the same thing?
Same.
Yes.
Yeah. But here I open GST 18%.
Okay. Can you stop presenting and start presenting again?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yes, we can see your screen. Yes, we can see GST. Okay, now here we have defined for CGST, SGST, and IGST. But now we have defined for CGST input, SGST input, and IGST input also. So in this only, you need to. Monica, that looks like. But everyone of you kind of understood the problem by now. What was the problem? Rishikesh, what is the problem? Could you kind of figure it out?
Yes, sir.
What was the problem that we're facing?
Yeah, sir.
What is the problem?
The problem, hello, my problem, sir.
No. We right now we were not able to apply the tax. So what is the problem?
So that GST 8% must have not lifted.
Sorry.
GST 18% should be selected in the tax template.
GST, can you strip it again? Sorry.
18%.
What should be 18%?
This tax template should have been maintained.
Sorry, Monika is taking it. This tax template should have been
mentioned there.
No, actually problem was she has selected CGST, HGST, not CGST, HGST input in GST 18%. She has to create a GST 18% with input accounts, which should have input accounts.
Yeah, Monika, we can see your screen. Monika?
Yes, sir.
You left, came and left twice, so I was wondering what happened. You could see actually your screen at that point also. Okay, so Aisha is saying something. So Aisha, can you repeat for Monika again?
Monika, in your...
Monika has left again. I don't know what is happening. She is joining and leaving. I mean, is it by design or is it an issue? Later join, then you can play with her.
Okay.
Is it raining in Pune or not yet?
I'm in Mumbai.
Sir,
I'm in Mumbai, so.
Oh, you're in
Hello, sir.
Yeah. Yes, Monika.
Hello.
Yes, we can hear you. Monika, we can hear you.
She is not able to listen. Hear us.
Oh, okay.
Hello.
Yes, Monika, we can hear you. Can you hear us?
No, sir. Now I hear you, but in some seconds we cannot hear you.
Okay. So can you share your screen now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, Vaishali, you can tell her what needs to be done.
Her screen is not visible yet.
Yeah, it is coming.
Is it visible, sir? Hello?
Yeah. It is visible.
Yeah.
Hello?
Yes, it is visible.
Hello. Why she is leaving meeting?
After she joining, after some time, she cannot hear us.
Oh, okay. Do you have her phone number? Can you talk to her on phone? Kind of step by step, because I think we can see her screen. There could be a lagging of voice that happens many times. Yes, Monica.
Hello.
Yes. Yes, we can see your screen also. Can somebody talk to her on phone and figure out what is the problem? Everybody has her number. Does anyone have her number?
Srikan, do we need to create two separate GST percentage, GST 18% for input and GST 18%?
Yes.
Okay. So that was the problem when we tried in first session, purchase session. At that time, we have only created GST 18% and that with the account, output account, GST 18 only. We haven't created GST 18 input. That's why in my case it was not working.
Right.
When I have created two separate accounts.
Yes, because I think the guidelines were only for the single account. So we followed the guidelines. But then there is no way we could link those accounts with the item tax template. Item tax template is actually a way to tell that. This should apply to the account head. So if you use multiple account heads, then we need 2 years link them.
Okay.
I guess we just followed them without understanding so much those types. Okay. But now I think it is clear that it has to be connected. So did you roll back that input and went ahead with?
I will try today because I haven't tried.
Okay, so Monica is saying she's facing some network issue. Okay, can somebody else volunteer now? Nupur, what about you? Are you there?
Yes, sir. Actually, sir, I am attending through phone. My kid is using my laptop because she is attending her class. So I am unable to, I will not be able to share my screen.
Okay.
I am joining through my phone, sir.
Okay. Rahul? Rahul, are you there?
Hello?
Yeah.
Yes, sir, my screen is visible now?
Yes, it is visible.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, so here you need to put three more rows, which will give CGST input, IGST input, and SGST
input. SGST input.
Yeah. So you can add three rows here. Thank you. Monica, are you adding these three rows?
Yes, sir. What?
Yeah, are you adding these three rows in GST 18%?
GST?
Yeah, here you have to add three rows. We have CGST 9% and all that, right? It's the same GST 18% in this screen only.
Yes, sir.
We have a table, right? Tax rates table, where we have CGST 9%, AGST 9%.
Yes, sir.
We have to add three more rows here in this table.
Okay.
Where we have to put CGST input. Yeah. And we have to put 9% here.
Okay.
For IGST, it should be 18% here. Yes, we can save this now and go ahead and check in our purchase order whether this effect is coming there or not. So this is okay. This is okay. Yes, this is okay. This is fine. This is what we have already had.
Yes, sir. Instead. No, sir. Now total is not showing.
No, you are going to go in purchase order. I think you are in the purchase and tax template. You have to go to the purchase order. Go to 09, yeah. 09 is probably can. Yes. Yeah. I said 25,000 for laptop. Now you go and select the purchase. Yes, now it is correctly working, right?
Okay, now amount is showing.
Now amount is showing. Perfect.
Save, sir, now?
Yeah, now I guess we can save, right? Yeah. Okay. So what should be the next step?
Purchase receipt.
Okay, cool. So right now, will there be change in the numbers that we have seen noted earlier in balance sheet or in profit and loss statement? So this is a question for everyone else. I'm just talking to Monica. But what about others? So let me call upon people. So Rahul, what do you think? What should be the impact by now? Whatever we've done till now, any number will change in balance sheet, profit and loss statement. Rahul?
Yes, sir.
Will there be any change? in profit and loss statement or in balance sheet?
No, sir. After we made a payment basis, payment transition, then changes will be reflected.
Okay. That's not correct, so much here, Rahul, because whenever we are doing, now there will not be any change, that's correct. But the moment we'll take the receipt, we'll receive something, we will see there's some change in the balance sheet. Because we're receiving something, our asset will increase. So there will be change in the balance sheet. Okay, so we'll see that. Let us do the purchase receipt. So Monika, can you just do the purchase receipt and then show the balance sheet to us?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you could manage to get them in order. Very good. Okay, now just can you see any difference in the balance sheet numbers? Let us look at balance sheet. So Rahul, can you just tell us, is there any difference in the balance sheet?
Bank account is same.
Hold on. This is a question for Rahul.
Yes, sir.
What is the difference in the balance sheet?
Application of fund is increased.
Yeah, so what is the account which has got affected? Is there any change in the balance sheet, any account? Account has got...
Sir.
Kutla account madhe farak disto hai ka? Mje kutla account badal hai ka? Balance badal hai kutla account madhe? Asset vaadle hai, but exactly change badal hai.
Exactly change the current asset madhe. Total asset for the current asset
kute exactly kutle account
stock asset vaadlele hai
stock asset vaadle stock in hand
yes
stock in hand has increased to 799,000. Perfect. Ata asset vaadle change apala liabilities mela paje. So can you just check liabilities now, Monika?
Yes,
liabilities are going to change sir. Okay. Yes, Rahul, could I change this to the liabilities today? Rahul, change the same person.
Yes, sir.
Change put a level side lock by change that, right?
A stock result not being.
Perfect. You would have 4,50,000. So, whatever happened is that the rest of the stock, so that has increased the asset value. But liability side la apna to stock received but not billed. Perfect. Thank you. Okay, Monika. So the purchase receipt you have got the stock. I think stock ledger may also will get that. Can you just look at the stock ledger also? I think there also we should obviously see the difference now. And we also may be interested to see the valuation rate also. I think take stock and not. So we see there's an addition of 10 item. And what is the valuation rate now? It has become
24,000.
Yes, it has increased. because it is now average of it, basically. Very nice. So now we are okay. Now we got a purchase receipt done. So we got the what the stock is in our warehouse now. Now what can we do next?
Purchase invoice.
Can we do purchase invoice or anything more urgent? Anything more urgent?
Sales invoice. Invoice.
Sales invoice.
We have to deliver that sales order.
Yes, so we have to first deliver, right? We can got it now. The whole idea why we did so much hurry is because we needed to deliver, right? So let us first deliver, then create an invoice there, and then create purchases. So in business, you want to first get money as early as possible and pay as late as possible. So first deliver, because without delivery we can't create a sales invoice. So we'll deliver, create a sales invoice, and then come back and create a purchase invoice. Then we'll get money first, cash first from the customer, and then we'll pay the supplier. Okay? So that is how it will go hand in hand. But we need to see what is the impact it is having on the statements. So we'll go ahead and create a delivery note, but that delivery note has to be created for the sales order which we have created.
Sir, here we need to select customer 03.
Yeah, but what we could do better, this is one way to do it. But a better way is to go ahead and pick up the sales order first. And from sales order, create a purchase, delivery. So unfortunately, this tax thing is not working so well for us. But all of the details are working fine. So it's better to go with that. Now you see that you deliver and bill, right? The status is for customer 03. So right now we have only one or two, but if there are multiple, this really comes handy.
Okay.
So here we can create a delivery mode. Okay, we see the green signal also in the table, right? We see the green thing, no longer orange. This we don't need to put.
Okay.
Yeah. Here it is missing green, so that means the stock is there. So perfect, you can now deliver. So we just need to check the action, the calendar. We have to take yes. Okay, so now we have delivered it. And when generally when we deliver it, we also send a sales invoice along with it. So we'll create an invoice also. By the way, just before we create an invoice, can we just check out? So before we just hold on here, let me ask Ravi. Ravi, what will the change? Now we have created the we delivered the items, right? So where do we should we see the changes?
Yes, sir.
आता आपण डिलिव्हर केलं ना मटेरियल 10 लॅपटॉप 10 डेस्कटॉप डिलिव्हर केले तर आता आपल्याला कुठे बॅलन्स शीट मध्ये काय फरक दिसायला पाहिजे
सर सर मी लास्ट तीन सेशनला ऍब्सेंट होतो सर त्यामुळे
अच्छा
काही माहिती नाही सर मला
थोडं फक्त रेकॉर्डिंग बघून घ्या
मला हां सर हां
ऋतुराज व्हॉट विल द डिफरन्स काय डिफरन्स आहे डिफरन्स येईल का पहिल्यांदा म्हणजे बॅलन्स शीट आता काय
फरक येईल आपण डिलिव्हर केलंय म्हणलं आपलं स्टॉक इन हँड कमी होईल क्वांटिटी
ओके पण म्हणजे कुठला अकाउंट फरक पडेल काय अंदाज
स्टॉक इन हँड आपले टॅक्सेस वाढतील सीजीएसटी आयजीएसटी आणि
वाढतील का आपण अजून इनव्हॉइस रेज नाही केलं
ओके
ठीक आहे आपण एक बघूया आय थिंक लेट अस चेक इट आउट निकिता सॉरी मोनिका कॅन यू जस्ट चेक इट आउट बॅलन्स शीट बघूया चेंज काय झाले बघूया ऋतुराज कॅन यू जस्ट चेक अस टेल अस व्हॉट हॅज हॅपन्ड
इन एक्सपेन्सेस आय थिंक स्क्रोल डाउन गुड सोल्स स्टॉक इन हँड आपला कमी होणार आहे
कमी झालाय दॅट्स करेक्ट सो दॅट इज वन थिंग आपण डिलिव्हर केल्यावर आय जस्ट गो डाऊन लायबिलिटी साइडला काय फरक पडलाय का तर स्टॉक रिसीव्ड बट नॉट बिल्ड इज स्टिल देअर 450,000 एनीवेअर डू यू सी एनी डिफरन्स
नो सर
कॅन यू जस्ट गो डाऊन मोनिका ओके सो नाव यू सी दॅट इज अ लॉस दॅट इज बीइंग सीन ते थोडस अबरप्ट झालंय कारण कसं आपण स्टॉक घेतला आणि देऊन टाकला विदाउट फिलिंग इट ऑल्सो सो जेव्हा आपण इनव्हॉइस सेल्स मध्ये रेज करू तेव्हा ते ऑटोमॅटिकली सेल्स मध्ये जाईल तोपर्यंत हा हे गिव्हन आउट समथिंग विदाउट अकाउंटिंग फॉर इट म्हणून तो प्रोव्हिजन लॉस दिसतो लेट अस गो टू प्रॉफिट अँड लॉस स्टेटमेंट अँड सी व्हॉट हॅपन्स See, the cost of goods sold is 480,000.
Yes,
it has increased. It has increased significantly, right? Karan to apan deliver kela. The cost of AI. There was a loss apan already booked zala. Because they have not billed it also. So apan jeva bill karu, teva aplyala te revenue recognize hoil. Apan fakta to ship kela. Tyachyamule to cost of goods sold vadli. Apan ti डिलिव्हर केलं बट वी आर नॉट बिल्ड इट सो राईट नाऊ शोईंग अस लॉस अँड विच इज अ बिग लॉस सो नाऊ वी सो दॅट इज पीपल जनरली डू अ डिलिव्हरी नोट अँड दे सेंड इनव्हॉइस अलॉंग विथ जर डिलिव्हर केलं का ते इनव्हॉइस पाठवून देतो कारण वन्स यू क्रिएट इनव्हॉइस देन इट विल शो एज अ प्रॉपर प्रॉफिट सो लेट अस क्रिएट दॅट सेल्स इनव्हॉइस अँड लेट अस कम बॅक टू दिस पेपर टू सी वेदर वी गेट टू द प्रॉफिट अँड विच टू सी द ते एनआयटीपी दिसते नाही तिथे इश्यू नाही येतो नाही जस्ट सेव्ह इट अगेन सेव्ह इट अगेन इट शोज कुड नॉट फाइंड रो नंबर वन इन्कम अकाउंट हा income account kuthe aicha padhe sir check kar
okay okay
I think in taxes
penalty is us ओके झालं ना आता आपण ते प्रॉफिट अँड लॉस आणि बॅलन्स शीट परत बघूया सबमिट झालं ना सेल्स इनव्हॉइस आपला काय दिसतोय बंपर प्रॉफिट दिसतोय की नाही 7 लाखाची सेल झालेला आहे एक्सपेन्स पण आपला झालेला आहे Ravi, can you see now?
No, sir. Stop hota hai, sir, screen.
Achha, okay.
Haan, lift pan ke lo, sarka sarka tez hota hai.
No, that looks sure, sir. Okay, I think we'll keep on writing the commentary in other. So basically, let's apply our optical mistake. You apply income of the 7 lakh furniture dhali liye. Because sales dhali hai. Achha, mode, एक्सपेन्सेस आपले वाढले होते आधीपासून पण आता वी आर रेकग्नाइज सो आफ्टर रेजिंग द इनव्हॉइस वी रेकग्नाइज द रेव्हेन्यू दॅट इज हाऊ इट इज फिक्स्ड इन द सिस्टम वेन एव्हर वी रेज इनव्हॉइस द रेव्हेन्यू इज रेकग्नाइज अँड दॅट्स द इनकम इज व्हॉट वी शो 7 लाख 54 अँड देन एक्सपेन्सेस आर देयर अँड द प्रॉफिट इज बीइंग शो नाउ यू कॅन गो टू द बॅलन्स शीट सायली बॅलन्स शीट मध्ये काय फरक दिसतोय का सायली
यस सर
बॅलन्स शीट मध्ये काय फरक दिसतोय का
देयर इज डिक्रीज इन स्टॉक असेट्स
हां स्टॉक मध्ये तो आपला मार्केट झाला होता ना स्टॉक इन हँड
3,62,000
हां डिलिव्हरी केल्यानंतर झालं तर सेल्स इनव्हॉइस केल्यानंतर काय फरक पडतो assets पहिले तर आपण asset side ला बघू asset side ला काय करतो परत stock in hand market झाला होता after delivery delivery केल्यानंतर sales इतवर वर रिस्क केला तेव्हा आता काय फरक पडला इकडे
in taxes tax assets
tax assets वाढले राइट because the नाही tax asset वाढले वाढले का ते आधी एवढं तर होतं
I think
liabilities should increase
ha itko kavar ho sakta hai adhi thoda ulad hote na ki past hote hai ha thoda hote tax assets same hai tax se badal nahi hai karan apan ajun te purchase invoice risk nahi hai sales invoice risk hai tamule asset side la kay farak padla ek line by line baka kuthe farak dishto hai to
debtors should
account receivables
account receivables account receivables yes account receivable मध्ये आता काय झालंय आपण invoice raise केलं म्हणजे आपण revenue recognize केलं आणि आपण cash आपल्याकडे आलेले आहे so it is it will come it is receivable it is not received yet it is receivable त्यामुळे ते receive debtors म्हणजे आपण त्यांच्याकडे आपलं येणं आहे we are going to get it त्याच्यामुळे आपण ते अमाऊंट इथे 7,78,000 आपल्याला इन आहे दॅट इज व्हॉट इज कम हियर अकाउंट रिसीव्ह सो दॅट असेट दॅट इज ऑल्सो असेट फॉर अस सो दॅट इज करेक्ट नाउ लेट अस लुक एट लायबिलिटीज काय फरक पडला आहे का लायबिलिटी मध्ये काय फरक पडला आहे का Shubhangi, can you just tell us what's the
stock receivable, but not bill. I think that added in.
Stock receipt but not billed. ते तसंच आहे, ते आधी पण होतं. अजून काय फरक पडलाय?
सीजीएसटी आयजीएसटी
हा ते वाढलंय, राईट. तर आपण सेल्स मध्ये रेज केलं, त्याच्यामुळे ते आपल्याला गव्हर्नमेंटला द्यावं लागणार होते. आपण रेज केलं. आता इथे मजा अशी आहे की आपण रेज केला टॅक्स च्या वरती आपल्या कस्टमरला, अजून एवढे पैसे कॅश आले नाहीये, पण आपली लायबिलिटी वाढलेली आहे गव्हर्नमेंटला द्यायची. आलं लक्षात? म्हणजे हा एक चॅलेंज असतो की आपल्याला टॅक्स पैसे मिळणार आहेत, कॅश आले नाही आपल्याला, पण आपल्याला लायबिलिटी वाढली. वी आर ओ नाव दिस मच मनी टू गव्हर्नमेंट. ऑब्व्हियसली गव्हर्नमेंट अमाऊंट लगेच देत नाही, इट जनरली हॅपन्स क्वार्टर बाय क्वार्टर. या क्वार्टरचं नेक्स्ट क्वार्टर, नेक्स्ट क्वार्टर, नेक्स्ट क्वार्टर. हा जो सीजीएसटी आहे त्यातून पे अप इन नेक्स्ट क्वार्टर, नॉट इमिजिएट, त्यामुळे इट्स ओके. तो एक फरक पडलाय. अजून काही फरक पडलाय का?
करंट लायबिलिटीज पण वाढले.
करंट लायबिलिटीज म्हणजे दोन गोष्टी वाढल्या, ती सीजीएसटी आणि एसजीएसटी. दॅट इज वेअर वी हॅव एनीथिंग एल्स? कॅन यू जस्ट गो डाऊन मोनिका? प्रॉफिट
प्रॉफिट लॉस मध्ये
हा तिथे तुम्हाला 3 लाख दिसत प्रॉफिट बेसिकली. दॅट इज व्हॉट यस. ओके गुड. तर लक्षात आलं ना, सेल्स इन्व्हॉइस घेतल्यानंतर आपल्याला प्रॉफिट आपला सॉरी रेव्हेन्यू रेकॉग्नाइज झाला, आणि म्हणून आजचा लॉस सुद्धा तो गायब झाला, आणि आपला अकाउंट रिसिवेबल मध्ये बॅलन्स दिसायला लागला की एवढ्याकडे पैसे यायची बाकी. आता लेटस डू दिस परचेस इन्व्हॉइस. आपण सप्लायर लोक इन्व्हॉइस आपला आलेला आहे बिल, वी हॅव टू रेज दॅट परचेस इन्व्हॉइस नंबर सिस्टम. लेटस गो अहेड. Now, in real life, things will happen a little here or there. People may not raise purchase emergency people. Thoda farak pada jayega, that could happen. Ata apan purchase emergency is the same logic log. Yeah, instead of creating purchase invoice from scratch, apan will go from what? Purchase emergency. Apan purchase receipt pasun banalo bara padhi. We already have purchase receipt pending. This means apala ti link karta. एअरवे मध्ये ते म्हणजे एक डिसिप्लिन फॉलो करायची अशी की जनरली आपण लिंक लावायची, तर मग आपला नंतर त्रास होत नाही डिबगिंग करताना. इथे आपल्याला दिसते काहीतरी आपलं कुठलं आपण त्याचं क्रिएट परचेस
इनव्हॉइस.
Okay, done. Now just hold on for a minute. स्नेहल काय फरक दिसेल आता आपल्याला बॅलन्स शीट मध्ये? एनी इमॅजिन?
हॅलो
या स्नेहल, बॅलन्स शीट मध्ये काय फरक दिसा अपेक्षा आपली?
परचेस इनव्हॉइस नंतर सर टॅक्सेस मध्ये चेंजेस असतील.
बरोबर, इनपुट साइड ना.
हा आणि नाही सर, फक्त टॅक्सेस मध्येच आय गेस चेंजेस असतील.
टॅक्स
असेट्स मध्ये फरक दिसतो सर.
फरक आहे सीजीएसटी इनपुट आणि एसजीएसटी इनपुट बराच फरक. अजून काही पुढे अजून काही फरक दिसतोय कुठे काही?
नाही सर.
ठीक आहे, लायबिलिटी साइड ला बघूया काय होतं.
currently abilities. Currently abilities कमी झाले असं
काहीतरी काहीतरी अकाउंट मध्ये होतो आधी ते गायब झालं आणि एक नवीन अकाउंट मध्ये आलं डायरेक्टली
अकाउंट पेएबल
हां अकाउंट पेएबल म्हणजे काय आपल्याला पेमेंट द्यायचं आणि एक अकाउंट गायब झालं आधी एक अकाउंट होतो तिथे डायरेक्टली मध्ये
रिसीवेबल होता आई थिंक
स्टॉक रिसीव्ड बट नॉट बिल्ड
बिल हां स्टॉक रिसीव्ड बट नॉट
बिल्ड आता कोणते बिल केलंय त्यामुळे अकाउंट्स पेएबल आहे सो इट्स अ लायबिलिटी आपल्याला पे करायचे आपण परचेस इनव्हॉइस रेज केले तो वी एक्नॉलेज की आपल्याला पे करायचे आपल्या सिस्टीम मध्ये आहे की आपल्याला पे करायचे दैट इज देयर
यस
पण ते आधी जो होतं ते निघून गेलं सो नाउ दैट थिंग इज डन आणि बाकी आय थिंक सेम बाकी प्रॉफिट पण थोडा असेल आधी जस्ट म्हणजे कॅन जस्ट गो डाऊन बिट बिट हा प्रॉफिट प्रोविजन प्रॉफिट आउट दिस दैट्स गुड आता मोनिका व्हाट इज द नेक्स्ट थिंग यू वांट टू डू
पेमेंट एंट्री
हां कुठली पेज करत आहे कुठली पेमेंट एंट्री पहिली करत आहे अगेन यू हैव टू गो विथ द ओरिजिनल डॉक्युमेंट अर्लियर डॉक्युमेंट रादर देन क्रिएटिंग अ पेमेंट एंट्री फ्रॉम व्हिच वन यू लव टू डू फर्स्ट रिसीव पेमेंट और पे पेमेंट
Receive payment.
Okay, good. That shows the business perspective. First receive payment, then pay. Okay, so upon receive payment, sorry, Aprila, purchase invoice, sorry, sales invoice will take. So I think we should go to sales invoice first. And in the current business. The link by luck, we don't need to worry too much about other things. I mean, sales invoice, one karun. इथे अनपेड दिसतच आहे सो देअर वी नीड टू क्रिएट अ पेमेंट सो दे स्टेटस पण ऑटोमॅटिक अपडेट होतो सो दॅट्स अ ॲडव्हान्टेज ऑफ इट सो दिस इज रिसीव पेमेंट ही पेमेंट बाकी आहे सर 7 लाख या सो वी कॅन डू दिस
सर यू वी नीड टू सिलेक्ट मोड ऑफ पेमेंट
चेक इज बाय डिफॉल्ट आहे दॅट इज ऑल्सो इफ यू डोंट सिलेक्ट इट इज कम्स अस चेक ओनली अच्छा हे आपण सेट नाही केलं ना
नाही डिफॉल्ट कॅश और बँक अकाउंट
हां दिस सेट डिफॉल्ट कॅश और बँक अकाउंट पण विल दिस गो इन अ कॅश अकाउंट देन कसं कुठे जाईल बँकेत जाईल पैसे की How you have been doing so far? Does the money go in the bank account or does it go in cash?
Should go in bank account.
But if you don't select anything, I think it anyway goes in bank account. So you don't select anything.
Okay.
Just go ahead and try to save it. It will last for the two things reference. It's all submitted. I think it must be going in cash. Anyway, let us go ahead.
We will let you take it. Submit Karuna, sir.
नाही कळलं ना काय
म्हणतो सबमिट करू का सर
सबमिट कुठे जाईल बँकेत जाईल की कॅश मध्ये जाईल अकाउंट जस्ट गो डाऊन अँड चेक कुठे जाते अकाउंट मध्ये अकाउंट बघा हा इकडे अकाउंट कुठे जाईल
कॅश
वी वॉन्ट गॉट टू कॅश तुम्ही आधी अकाउंट ट्रान्सफर कॅश मध्येच केलं होतं का
वरती चेक सिलेक्ट करून आहे का ना खाली बँक सिलेक्ट कर
इथे चेक करून
खाली बँक सिलेक्ट कर अकाउंट पेड टू जिथे कॅश एंट्री आहे ना
नाही होते ते सिलेक्ट
अलाव करत नाही
नाही अलाव नाही
ओके माझे ते अलाउ करते
ती सेटिंग करायला लागला आपला डिफॉल्ट मध्ये ऍक्च्युअली इंडेक्स ट्रान्स जस्ट डिफॉल्ट मध्ये झाली होती सेटिंग ती की चेक म्हटलं तर गो इन द बँक अकाउंट इन द बँक ऑफ मार्कस पेज त्याच्यामध्ये बहुतेक मेसेज एंट्री ठीक आहे आपण कॅश करून घेऊया आणि मग नंतर ट्रान्सफर करूया कॅश आपण बँकेत डिपॉझिट करू तसंही चालेल
हॅलो सर एक क्वेश्चन होतं तिथे वायर ट्रान्सफर म्हणून एक आहे मोड ऑफ पेमेंट
वायर ट्रान्सफर म्हणजे एनईएफटी आपल्या भाषेमध्ये इंडियामध्ये अदरवाईज युएसमध्ये तो वायर ट्रान्सफर
म्हणतात
ऑनलाइन ट्रान्सफर
ओके
आपल्या कोणामध्ये ऍक्च्युअली एनईएफटी पण असतो जर आरटीजीएस वगैरे एनईएफटी सगळे ऑनलाईन ट्रान्सफर जे आहे दॅट इज बेसिकली वायर ट्रान्सफर तुम्हाला तो अकाउंट नंबर आयएफसी कोड होऊन द्यावा
कंपनी बँक अकाउंट मध्ये सिलेक्ट केलं तिथे ट्राय कर बँक अकाउंट नाही का
नाही आता एक काम करा कंपनी मध्ये जायचं कंपनी मध्ये जाऊन डिफॉल्ट सेटिंग करून
द्यायचं
बँकेमध्ये कंपनी मध्ये जा कंपनी रेकॉर्ड मध्ये आणि तिकडे जाऊन तिथे सेट करा कंपनी लिस्ट मध्ये जाऊन अनेक कॉम्प्युटर्स तिकडे बँक असणार कुठे डिफॉल्ट डिफॉल्ट बँक असं कुठे असेल बघा अकाउंट सेल डिफॉल्ट बँक अकाउंट तिकडे ते तुम्ही तुमचं बँकेचं अकाउंट सेशन सेव्ह करा नाव यू पहिले ते डिस्कार्ड करा नवीन बनवा त्याच्यामध्ये बेटर मध्ये
सर इथे पेमेंट एंट्री 1 येते
हां एक्चुअली ते तीच क्लिक करा क्लिक ऑन दैट पेमेंट एंट्री क्लिक ऑन पेमेंट एंट्री हां ते ड्रॉप दाखवते ठीक आहे ते ओपन करा आणि हां आणि चेक बघा तर काय डज इट गिव एरर This is default cash or including mode of payment check. The check will click kara. Just click on that check. And ithe add row kara. Company now taka. And here default account. Bank is taka. Save kara. And just account check kara. Kaya hota taka. Tithe ka change hai bol. सेव्ह करून मला चेक करून घ्या अकाउंट मध्ये आपलं काय सेव्ह करून पाहू का आणि जस्ट गो इन अकाउंट खाली हा इथे बघा काय येते या नाही इथे अजून कॅशच घेते यू कॅन कॅन यू चेंज दिस हियर
ओके ओके नाउ चेंज
ओके सेव्ह करून घ्या हा तर वी नीड टू गेट द चेक नंबर आणि हे आजची तारीख टाकून दोन आणि रेफरन्स बाय सम नंबर यू कॅन पुट इन जिथे डेट म्हणजे बाजूलाच एक आधी एक एक रेफरन्स नंबर होता हा तो टाकून ओके तर आपल्याला पैसे मिळाले इकडून ओके होल्ड ऑन सुमित व्हाट डू वी सी एज अ डिफरेंस इन प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस स्टेटमेंट नाउ सुमित ठीक है. शुभांगी आर यू देयर?
यस सर.
हाँ काय फरक पडला का
अकाउंट रिसीवेबल आई थिंक रिमूव्ह झाले.
ओके बॅलन्स शीट मध्ये ठीक लेट अस चेक दैट आउट. मोनिका बॅलन्स शीट बघूया आपण. अकाउंट रिसीवेबल गायब झालं. हो झालं गायब. पण अजून काय फरक पडला का
बँक अकाउंट मधलं? आपण
येस बँक अकाउंट पैसे आले. दॅट्स करेक्ट. सो दॅट इज डन. लायबिलिटी साइडला काय फरक पडलाय का? फरक पडायला पाहिजे का लायबिलिटी साइडला?
नाही
कारण आपण एनीवे अकाउंट पेबल आहेतच आणि ऍसेट मध्ये ऍडजस्ट झालं बेसिकली. त्याच्यामुळे इथे काय फरक पडला? परफेक्ट. आता आपण लास्ट पाहिली पेमेंट एंट्री टू पे टू द वेंडर. तर शुभांगी काय फरक पडेल बॅलन्स शीट मध्ये एकदा पेमेंट केलं तर?
परत पेमेंट केले तर
आपण बॅलन्स शीट मध्ये काय फरक पडेल पेमेंट केले तर?
मायनस होतील.
कशामधून?
अकाउंट बॅलन्स मधून.
बँकेच्या अकाउंट मधून. दॅट्स परफेक्ट. आणि लायबिलिटी साइड ला काय होईल? आपण पेमेंट केलं का ते तिथून गायब होते बेसिकली. बरोबर ना? पेमेंट आता ते पेएबल आहे. पेमेंट केलं का ते तिथून गायब झालं. बरोबर ना? आपण बघूया तर पेमेंट करूया. लेट अस डू दॅट पेमेंट अँड विल कम बॅक टू बॅलन्स शीट आफ्टर दिस. सो आय थिंक वी हॅव टू गो विथ परचेस इनव्हॉइस. एक अनपेड आहे.
सर आता इथं क्रेडिटर्सच राहणार ना?
हो बँकेतून पैसे दिले जाणार. क्रेडिटर्स ते अकाउंट्स पेएबल आहे बेसिकली. क्रेडिटर्स अकाउंट.
Okay sir, is now submitted.
Huh. Let us show us the balance sheet. Shubhangi, bagas balance sheet madhe kai fark dishto ka?
Yes sir. Account balance kami jhale.
Ha.
Account payable pan
remove. Right. Perfect. ओके सर यू कॅन लुक ॲट अ प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस स्टेटमेंट. तिथे आपलं काही फरक पडला असेल. ओव्हरऑल वी लुक ॲट प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस स्टेटमेंट. हाऊ मच मनी वी मेड. ओके सो सेम 784,000 इज अ सेल. एक्सपेन्सेस 4,80,000. ओव्हरऑल द प्रॉफिट इज व्हेरी गुड फॉर द इयर. इट्स अराउंड 3,04,000. Okay, so that kind of concludes our entire cycle. I think pretty much on time in a way. I hope this was useful, right? I mean, not only we run through all the transactions, but also we saw the impact. Balance sheet la factor. And I think by now you also figured out that any mistake anywhere will affect it in multiple places. Because it's well connected, obviously. It's a model, CRM, passing, Actually, you can go to CRM now. Look at the opportunity list. That it is only shows a quotation. So it shows that all these are a reached quotation. So basically, the status is automatically updated. Okay. And if you go to that quotation, you will see that it is. So if you go to the quotation list, you will just go to the quotation list. Quotation list. You can also see that ordered. It is order zalele. So status update zale automatically. Order. So all those. Yeah. So basically. The whole idea about linking these documents is that you get a whole good audit trail, what is happening, how things are happening. And one is that ERP itself will connect things, connect the dots, so to say. And we also follow a discipline along with it so that, you know, these dots are correctly connected. Otherwise, it can create a mess out of it. But otherwise, if you follow it systematically, then things happen correctly. So this is what the purpose of this demonstration. We didn't get time to resolve the issue. So what I suggest, this is what I told Kanhaiya also. Is Kanhaiya online? No, he's not there. So what I told him is that he will check with you, or you may kind of talk to him directly, that those of who we feel that you have got some errors in your system and you are unable to resolve them, we can have an add-on session. So we had a plan for only 10 sessions so far. And actually, we would have finished. I think we lost one session in between because of we need to resolve issues and all that. But we can do add-on session provided you know, you need that help. So those of who we were not able to figure out what the error is in your system, you can request Kanhaiya to see whether we can have an additional session. So once we get a good number of people, or I think even if there is one person also, we will do the session for that person. But that request has to come from you. As far as the plan was concerned, we are done with the plan of 10 sessions. But if any one of you need additional help, please ask for it. And obviously, we'll open the session for everyone. So even if you don't have an issue, you can still attend that session to know what are the issues faced by others. And maybe in the process, you'll learn something more. But that is on demand in a way. That session will be on demand. Only if you ask for it, we'll have it. Otherwise, we'll not have it. Otherwise, we are done with this particular session. There is also a request from both Kanhaiya and Gupteshwar to have a session on manufacturing model. The only challenge in manufacturing is a little long. I mean, even if you take a simplistic scenario, it takes a long time to do it. So we're just deliberating. We'll just think through it. And we may do it. But if you do it, we'll do it next week, not immediately. Or maybe next week kind of thing. But we may do two additional sessions that we'll see. Depending on, we'll also do evaluation of it. I guess we will also ask you your feedback about it. And if you found the whole thing is very useful, then we'll do the two additional sessions. Or if you find this was not a great way of learning, because we're doing online and, you know, a lot of network issues and this kind of thing. Or the approach that we are doing, you know, doing it kind of doing nothing by doing kind of approach. If you see it was not very effective, then we'll not have it, because that is even more complicated. Because there's a bill of material, there is operations, there are many things that we need to do. So it will be more difficult than sales and purchase cycle. So we'll take a stock of how did you find it, this particular session, did you find it useful, did you learn anything out of it, and so on. And then decide for the manufacturing. So that's all from my side. Any comments, questions from any one of you?
Hello, sir.
Yes, sir.
सर इन स्टॉक लेजर हाउ दैट वैल्यूएशन रेट इज कैलकुलेटेड सर
या सो
डू वी नीड टू डू एनी सेटिंग्स और डू वी नीड टू गिव एक्स्ट्रा इनपुट टू इट टू गेट कैलकुलेटेड बिकॉज व्हाइल आई वाज वाचिंग माय स्टॉक लेजर देयर द वैल्यूज ऑफ इनकमिंग what is this column but valuation rate and the other value besides it both are same
that is because see what happens suppose you got 5-10 items of 100 rupees each that is 1000 rupees valuation which is okay which is standard to start with I mean the first batch that comes in of 10 items with 100 rupees will get 1000 rupees as a valuation rate sorry 100 rupees valuation rate. So we just take it 100 rupees for one item. So that's a valuation rate, basically.
Okay, okay.
The challenge is once you get a next set of batch items with a different valuation rate. Suppose you got first 10 items at 100 rupees each. The next one you got 110 rupees each. Now you got a stock of 20 items. Some 10 items with 100 rupees and 10 items with 110 rupees. So the valuation rate of these 20 items is now 105 rupees. Are you getting it? Because it has to use that valuation rate to calculate cost of goods sold. So when you sell 10 out of it, it doesn't know which 10. So it takes an average rate.
Okay.
That is how it is doing. There are different ways. Actually, I mentioned that to Vaishali last time. I'll discuss that. We didn't get time for valuation. But valuation rate is something which is a little... I mean, there are different ways to do valuations. So I'll share that link. Or if there is an on-demand session, just put that in demands. What are the things that you want to cover in that session? And we can cover in that session.
Why am I asking this question? Because, sir, in quiz number 6 there was a question what is the valuation rate of consumable to something question was there and while I saw that stock ledger I got the valuation rate as 60 for consumable to but the correct answer was 57 so I was not able to understand why
because the stock did you do stock reconciliation
yes sir
so there the rate was 50 rupees initial that we got consumables at 50 rupees
okay
and then the next set we got at 60 rupees so consumable 02
okay
so that means your stock reconciliation was not correctly done
okay
if it is showing 60 means your stock reconciliation entry was not done in
okay okay okay
that's why you got 60 yeah, so you need to go and check that
okay sir okay
okay Any other questions? Okay, then we close the session and as I said, you can put a demand for additional session, doubt clearing session. But please put a specific demand that this is an issue that I'm not able to resolve myself. So we need a session, something like that. I think Kanaya will anyway reach out to you, but you can also reach out to him and ask for it. And accordingly, we'll schedule the session if there is. Even there is only one request, we'll do it for that person. But we will open for everyone to attend. If you have time and interest, you can always come and attend the session. Thank you very much and have a great week ahead.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.